Welcome to AS IAS Institute. This is our second part of UPSC Prelims 2019 GS Paper 1 detailed discussion. In part 1, we have covered question number 1 to 25. Now looking at question number 26. So the 26th question is, which one of the following is not the most likely measure the government RBI takes to stop the slide of Indian rupee? So Indian rupee has been, you know, devaluing in against the dollar. So for stopping this slide of Indian currency, steps have been taken. What is not a likely step? Out of these four, three are likely, one is not. So which one is it? You have to find out. A is curbing imports of non-essential goods and promoting exports. So when we are importing, we are paying in dollars. When you are importing from a foreign country, they would want payment in hard currency. So we are giving out dollars. So when we are giving out dollars as such, then, you know, our own currency, it gets affected because, you know, as against the rupee, dollars demand is more. So that's how it goes. So curbing imports of non-essential goods and promoting exports. When we promote exports, so when exports are promoted, we are paying, we are getting paid in dollars. So of course that is beneficial. So one is correct. Second, encouraging Indian borrowers to issue rupee denominated masala bonds. So this is again, rupee denominated masala bonds are bonds in which borrowings take place, in which money would be, Indian borrowers are going to repay in rupee terms, not in dollar terms. So that is also beneficial for rupee. Third is easing conditions related to external commercial borrowings. Means external commercial borrowings are entities borrowing. So easing conditions when we are allowing external commercial borrowings to take place means we are allowing our borrowers to allowing our citizens or nationals to borrow from foreign entities, and when they are borrowing, they are bringing in dollars again. And D is following an expansionary monetary policy. So an expansionary monetary policy basically means when government is spending more. So when government increases spending within the economy, means it is putting in more rupee in the economy. If there is more rupee in the economy, means there is less demand for rupee. So more supply means less demand. Less demand means the currency would fall. So for 26th number, you can understand that D is the correct option. Expansionary monetary policy is not used for currency, for stopping currency slide. Then question 27 is, the RBI's recent directives related to storage of payment system data, popularly known as data diktat, command the payment system providers that, so this is, was prominently in news, very much covered in current affairs. So storage of payment systems data, so when there are these payment systems in which monetary transactions are being recorded, so they, when they are operating in India, they should ensure that entire data is stored on servers within India. So that's what the data diktat is, that data should not be stored on servers located outside India. They should be stored on servers located in India. So this has been the demand of the government, and the RBI's recent directive was on this line. So what does it provide? There are three statements given, and it says which of these are correct. So first it says the payment system providers are commanded that they should ensure that entire data relating to payment systems operated by them are stored in systems only in India. So that is of course true, that the data should be stored on systems in India, and they shall ensure, so they should not be on foreign servers, they should be on Indian servers. So Indian citizens' data should not be going outside. Then second is, they shall ensure that the systems are owned and operated by PSUs, public sector enterprises. So there's no such condition. There will be, themselves will be, the payment systems are owned and operated by private entities, foreign entities too, so foreign companies. So this second statement is not correct. Third is, they shall submit the consolidated system audit report to the Comptroller and Auditor General of India, CAG, by the end of the calendar year. So CAG does not directly deal with any private entity. It is actually for auditing government accounts as such. So third statement is also incorrect. We've never heard of CAG with respect to payment systems like that, and does not fall in place too. So the correct answer here is, and you don't have any 1 and 3 option too. So that is also clear. So here you can see 2 is incorrect. When you know 2 is incorrect, means you're left with 1 only and 3 only. So 1 is the correct answer, 1 only, A. So that is the correct answer, you can see, A. Then question 28 is, which of the following adopted a law on data protection and privacy for its citizens known as General Data Protection Regulation in April 2016 and started implementation of it from 25th May 2018? So its implementation has recently started, and you must have heard about this. This was prominently in news, General Data Protection Regulation. It is related to the European Union. So the correct answer here is C, and it has been covered in news as such. So GDPR has been quite often covered in news too. This is 22nd Jan 2019 news. Here you can see France slaps 50 million euro fine on Google under new law. So this is General Data Protection Law mentioned here, you can see. Here you can see the detail given. So it's written EU strict general data protection regulation. So what is it all about is also detailed out here. Even October 2018 news covered regarding data dictato. You can see this is 10 number news here. So this is regarding payment systems operators, how they have to keep data only on servers in India. So that is also detailed here, you can see. So these payment systems, prominent payment systems in India who were reluctant to comply are American Express, Visa, MasterCard. So this was in news, you can see. So here you can see RBI stated intent, which is not only about easy access of data, but of protecting Indian citizens' data against rampant sharing outside India. It should not be shared outside India. It should be stored on servers in India only. So this is regarding this data localization rules. Then 29th question is, recently India signed a deal known as Action Plan for Prioritization and Implementation for Cooperation Areas in the Nuclear Field. With which of the following countries? So there are four countries mentioned here. The correct answer here is actually Russia. This is actually covered here. You can see in the Economic Times paper in October 2018, Russia and India signed this action plan. And this was to increase the number of nuclear reactors in India, even having a second site apart from Kudankulam where the nuclear plants are located. So six nuclear power projects at a new site in India would be provided for. And also you should know that India and Russia are involved in joint projects for nuclear power plants in Bangladesh too. And it said Russia is currently the only foreign partner for nuclear reactors in India, with the first plant in Kudankulam. So this was an action plan signed with Russia. Then next question is, the money multiplier in an economy increases with which one of the following? So there are four options given. So first of all, you should understand what is money multiplier. This is a basic terminology in economics. So when you study economics and you study about M1, M2, broad money, narrow money, you come across money multiplier too. So here you can see we have given the link. So, and it is, the explanation is also given here. You can see the size of the multiplier depends on the percentage of deposits that banks are required to hold as reserves. So money, it is the money that is used to create more money. So it is calculated by dividing total bank deposits by the reserve requirement. So how much deposits are there and how much is the requirement, you know, the reserve requirement. So this is the money multiplier, you can see. Detailed out here. Even the formula as such is there for money multiplier, means the reserves go in the denominator because that has to be kept as reserves. So that will reduce money multiplier, and money supply, when it increases, it increases money multiplier. So that's the idea. So here you can see the question is, money multiplier in an economy increases with which one of the following? So when will it increase? If there is increase in cash reserve ratio, if the reserves requirements are increased, then money multiplier actually reduces, because it's an inverse relation. This goes in denominator. Same for statutory liquidity ratio. So A and C are excluded. And option B is increase in the banking habit of the population and increase in the population of the country. So of course the correct answer is increase in the banking habit. So when deposits increase, then money multiplier will have a positive effect. So correct answer for 30 is B. The next question is 31. Consider the following statements about PVTGs, particularly vulnerable tribal groups. So first of all, I'd like to say this is also a very difficult question, because there are two specific PVTGs mentioned. So, and this is very factual. So your first statement is PVTGs reside in 18 states and one union territory. So yes, this is true. Particularly vulnerable tribal groups come across in news quite often, but still this is very specific detailed news required. So whether this is correct or wrong, number one, we may not be able to say. And you can see that one of the four statements are wrong. So which one of these four statements are wrong? That if you know specifically, this is that there are 95 PVTGs officially notified in the country. So if you have come across particularly vulnerable tribal groups and you register this fact that there are 75 PVTGs officially notified in the country so far, and it has not changed for many years now. So even if you know this one information, factual information correctly, then you may be able to solve this question. If this is surely incorrect, question number statement number 3, then 1, 2 and 4 are correct. 2 is correct. This everybody would know. A stagnant or declining population is of course one of the criteria for determining particularly vulnerable tribal groups. And this is very factual. So the only way to know this, if you are sure of 75 PVTGs, then you can mark the option 1, 2 and 4, C as the correct answer. So this is it. The next question, 32, is with reference to the Constitution of India, prohibitions or limitations or provisions contained in ordinary laws cannot act as prohibitions or limitations on the constitutional powers under Article 142. So this is actually talking about Article 142, that constitutional powers which have been given to an entity, a constitutional entity under Article 142, its powers cannot be limited through ordinary laws. Ordinary laws cannot act as prohibition. So that's what it means. It's a legal terminology used here. So basically you should know what Article 142 is about. So if you are knowing that Article 142 is under judiciary, you would be easily able to solve this question. A statement is regarding Election Commission. B statement is regarding Supreme Court. You can see Supreme Court is not constrained in the exercise of its powers by law made by Parliament. So this is the correct answer. C is regarding financial crisis and power of President to declare financial emergency, and C, D is regarding state legislature. So first B is the correct answer, and S is current affairs question. This was in news quite often. So here you can see even in our news we have covered with respect to Babri Masjid case also. Article, first news itself over here you can see. Article 142 was mentioned here. In its 40-page judgment, Supreme Court had invoked its extraordinary constitutional powers in under Article 142, that it cannot be constrained because of ordinary laws of the Parliament. And again, it was there, you can see, in this Nauri case as such too. So this is again covered in news, you can see. So this was the Dowry news here. In the 8th news here, you can see down here. So again, Supreme Court had stated how it passed this order on dowry cases by invoking extraordinary powers of the Supreme Court to administer complete justice under Article 142 of the Constitution. So here, because one Article 142 has prominently been in use too quite often, these are just two examples put forth here. So for 32, the answer is B. Question number 33, it says, with reference to the legislative assembly of a state, consider the following statements. First is, the governor makes a customary address to members of the house at the commencement of the first session of the year. So president also makes a customary address to members of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha at the commencement of the first session of the year. So when for state central legislature, there is such a provision, for state legislature too, this customary address takes place. You can see this is the word customary use, means it is not some mandatory, it's just a custom. So yes, this is correct. And second statement is, when a state legislature does not have a rule on a particular matter, it follows the Lok Sabha rule on that matter. So again, here there is a little dicey aspect, because it has to follow is not the case. It follows means it always follows, again is not the case. So here the answer may be either A, one only, or C. So we'll have to see what the correct answer is. Then question number 34. So this is regarding 33. 34, you have, the United Nations Convention Against Corruption has a protocol against smuggling of migrants by land, sea and air. Then it talks again of United Nations Convention Against Corruption, first ever legally binding global anti-corruption instrument. And then you have UN Convention Against Transnational Organized Crime. So UNTOC and UNCSE both are discussed. Transnational Organized Crime, transnational means nations, national citizens transaction taking place. Transnational organized crime is basically regarding trafficking too. So when you talk of a protocol under Convention Against Corruption called smuggling of migrants, so this actually falls under UNTOC, not UNCAC. So first statement is clearly wrong. So this is the way UPSC frames questions too, putting mismatching things. So looking at all three statements also, you can clearly see that smuggling migrants cannot come under corruption, rather it falls more under transnational organized crime. So one statement is wrong. Two is correct. So when you know first statement is wrong, You can see you have eliminated two options, means your answer can be B or C. So whether third statement is correct or incorrect is what it depends on. So this third statement says the highlight of the UN Convention Against Transnational Organized Crime is the inclusion of a specific chapter aimed at returning assets to their rightful owners from whom they have been taken illegally. So this is regarding transnational organized crime, and returning assets actually comes under corruption. So again, what they have done with one is what they have done with three. They have interchanged the two. So instead of UNPOC being mentioned here and UNCSE, so actually one and three both are wrong. So when one and three both are wrong, the only option you're left with is two and four. So it is the first ever treaty is true, and UN Office on Drugs and Crimes is mandated by its member states to assist the implementation of both is also correct. So basically this question actually does not fall under recent current affairs, the very old current affairs. So it was long back that, you know, these conventions have been signed by India too. So, but then by simple elimination also sometimes the way questions are framed, understanding that you can write, you can mark the correct answer. Then 35, it is, as per recent amendments to the Indian Forest Act 1927, forest dwellers have the right to fell the bamboos grown on forest areas. So bamboo has been prominently in news. You should know Indian Forest Act has been amended to declassify bamboo as a grass, and you know, classify bamboo as a grass and declassify it from the category of trees. Bamboo is actually scientifically, taxonomically a grass, not a tree. But colonial rules were such, colonial laws were such that bamboo was defined as a tree and not a minor forest produce, so that forest dwellers cannot have access to bamboo. So this was a change which recently has been done. So my first statement is correct. Second statement says, as per Scheduled Tribes and Other Traditional Forest Dwellers Act 2006, bamboo is a minor forest produce. Yes. Then third statement is, according to the same act, that allows ownership of minor forest produce to forest dwellers. So yes, that is also correct. So correct answer here is B, 2 and 3. So here you can see. So these acts have prominently been in news. Even bamboo being declared as a minor forest produce and a grass has been discussed in news. So this is 7th May 2018 news. You can look here down. When nectar turned poison for bamboo. So in this coverage, we have mentioned. So basically, it was done earlier in 2017. But then still, it has been in news. You can see President Ram Nath Kovind's ordinance in November 2017 amended the Indian Forest Act to rid bamboo, which is botanically a grass, was rid of its tree tag. It had tree tag for 90 years. So now, since it is a grass, it is exempted from requiring permits for felling or transportation. So it keeps coming in news. Bamboo is no longer a tree, but it is a grass. So you should know about it. Then next is number 36. Which article of the Constitution of India safeguards one's right to marry the person of one's choice? So right to marry had also been prominently used in the Hadia case of Kerala, where the female actually married a Muslim man, but the father had kept her under house arrest, and the case went on in the courts, reached up to the Supreme Court. So one has right to marry the person of one's choice. So this is safeguarded under which article of the Constitution? So actually majority of such rights are derived from Article 21 of the Constitution, which is right to life. So it's Article 21 which will be the correct answer here too. So 36, the answer is B. Then 37. According to the Indian Patents Act, a biological process is to create seed can be patented in India. Then second is, in India, there is no intellectual property appellate board. So this is clearly incorrect. Second statement, there is an intellectual property appellate board. When you read news items, you clearly know that yes, there's an appellate board. So second statement is clearly incorrect. Means you are left with A and C. That is 1 and 3 or 3 only. So then it depends on whether statement one is correct or not. So three has to be correct. Plant varieties are not eligible to be patented in India. So first statement is, according to Indian Patents Act, a biological process to create a seed can be patented in India. So whether a biological process can be patented or not, this is a little dicey question. Here you can see we have covered. So it says Indian patents law prohibits patents on any plants and animals or any process through a genetically modified organism. Through which a genetic is created, as long as it is purely biological. Means no patent is allowed for biological processes. So only notable exception is microorganisms like BT cotton, etc. are microorganisms used. So for purely biological processes, there is no patent allowed. But you can see the TRIPS agreement allows government to exclude essentially biological objects and processes. But microorganisms, microbiological and non-biological processes are not exempted from patents. So when you read this in that context, you can clearly say that according to Indian Patents Act, the biological process to create a seed can be patented in India is clearly incorrect. So when statement 1 is incorrect, you are left with only statement 3. So 37, the correct answer is C. Then for 38, it says, consider the following statements. Environment Protection Act 1986 empowers the government of India to, so number one, state the requirement of public participation in the process of environmental protection and the procedure and manner in which it is sought. So under Environment Protection Act, there is a provision for environment impact assessment, and under environment impact assessment, public consultation is required, public participation is required, and it's clearly stated what are the process. So in that context, statement one is correct. Second statement says, Environment Protection Act lays down the standards for emission or discharge of environmental pollutants from various sources. So this is also correct. So for 38, the correct answer is C. Both 1 and 2. Then next is question number 39. As per solid waste management rules in India, which one of the following statements is correct? First one, waste generator has to segregate waste into 5 categories. So solid waste management rules had prominently been in use, and if you have read about it, you should know waste generator had to segregate waste into 3 categories. This has been covered in current affairs too. So this is February 2018 news actually. So you can see that old news is also asked by UPSC. So here you have this, you know, pollution and related news. So here's the coverage. So this is regarding solid waste management rules. So municipal solid waste management rules, you can see it talks of source segregation of waste into 3 categories. So it's clearly stated, you can see 3 streams. So for option 1, when it says has to segregate waste into 5 categories, A is clearly incorrect. So which of the following statements is correct is the question. So out of A, B, C, D, only 1 is correct. So A is incorrect. B says the rules are applicable to notified urban local bodies, notified towns and all industrial townships. So it has wide coverage as such, which has been given for the municipal solid waste rules. So it is applicable for, you can see, a huge number of local bodies. So that way you can see it's extended to more regions. So that is why second statement is also incorrect. The third statement is rules provide for exact and elaborate criteria for identification of sites for landfills and waste processing facilities. And D says it is mandatory on the part of waste generator that the waste generated in one district cannot be moved to another district. So why district wise segregation? There is no district specific. It may be state. If it is state, then again, it may be correct. But when it talks district to district, there is no such differentiation made. So D statement is incorrect. Again, B statement, you have this keyword. You can see this is only, that it is applicable only to these regions. Again, that should give you an inkling that this may be incorrect statement. And C statement is actually correct. So out of 39, 4 options, C is the correct answer. So it is a little difficult question, but then with a little elimination process, you can come to the correct answer. Then question number 40. So here you have, as per the Industrial Employment Standing Orders, Central Amendment Rules 2018, it gives 2 statements. If rules for fixed term employment are implemented, it becomes easier for the firms, companies to lay off workers. So fixed term employment means employment similar to contract basis for a fixed term. So of course, it will become easy for firms, companies to lay off workers. They can easily hire and fire. So that is there. Second is, no notice of termination of employment shall be necessary in case of temporary worker. So if it's a temporary worker, there is no need for a notice of termination of employment. So that is also correct. So 40, the correct answer is C. Then 41, you have, in the context of digital technologies for entertainment, consider the following. So this talks of augmented reality and virtual reality, and again it has interchange, you should know. Augmentation, augmenting means enhancing. So when it is augmented reality, you know, so it's actually, you can see, a simulated environment is created in physical world is completely shut out. That is incorrect for augmented reality. It's actually virtual reality. So first statement is incorrect. Second statement says in virtual reality, images generated from a computer projected onto real life objects or surroundings. So augmented reality with use of technology, mobile apps, etc. You get augmented reality, more information like Google Lens or any such maps, Google Maps, they give you more information. So that is augmented reality. So you know, images generated from a computer projected on real life objects or surroundings. So that is interchanging. So statement one and two both are incorrect. One content is for virtual reality and two explanation is for augmented reality. So one and two are incorrect. So when one and two are incorrect, you're left with three and four or four only. So we'll have to see it basically on statement three whether it is correct or not. It says augmented reality allows individuals to be present in the world and improves the experience using the camera or smartphone or PC. So through camera you improve the experience. So that's what augmented reality. So three statement is correct. And fourth says virtual reality closes the world and transposes an individual providing complete immersion experience. So virtual reality, like, you know, gaming experience when you have your that entire device on your eyes. So it's like virtual reality simulation being done. So that actually is total immersion experience. So three and four are correct. So the correct answer here is B, 41B. Then 42, you have the word Denisovan is sometimes mentioned in media in reference to so fossils of a kind of dinosaurs and early human species. So Denisovan was in news. You can see we have also covered in news Denisovan. So here it is. You see a distinct species of primitive humans that roamed the Eurasian continent. It's covered in news here. So the last news item, I suppose, the DNA reveals first interspecies child. So this is August 2018 news, the last news item below. So this is the Denisova. Denisova, a distinct species of primitive humans. So when you have heard of the term, then you would be able to link it, and it is B is the correct answer, an early human species. Then 43, it says, with reference to recent developments in science, which one of the following is not correct? So it talks of functional chromosomes. It says functional chromosomes can be created. So chromosomes, DNA, what is it all about? You should know. We have quite often covered in biotechnology in news whenever it comes up, SNT related news. So functional chromosome, it says, can be created by joining segments of DNA taken from cells of different species. So chromosomes are distinct for each species. So you can't have different species cells and DNA taken and then combined to have a functional chromosome. So A statement is actually incorrect. B says pieces of artificial functional DNA can be created in laboratories. This has actually been done. C says a piece of DNA taken out from an animal cell can be made to replicate outside a living cell in a laboratory. This has also been accomplished. And it says cells taken from plant and animals can be made to undergo cell division in laboratory petri dishes. So this is, of course, you know, in vitro fertilization, everything takes place. So cell division takes place. So D is also correct. So here the correct answer, which of the statements is not correct? The correct answer is A. So 43 is A. Then 44 you have. So question 44 is a digital signature is. So a digital signature is, you know, you digitally sign documents or you digitally sign, you know, any platform which you are accessing. So electronic record is, it is an electronic record basically that identifies the certifying authority issuing it. Sometimes you see that it is, you know, there is no digital signature here. So whether you trust the source or not, questions are raised when you access anything on internet. So a digital signature, of course, is an electronic record that identifies the certifying authority issuing it. Second, it says it is used to serve as a proof of identity of an individual to access information or server on internet. And third, it says it's an electronic method of signing an electronic document and ensuring that the original content is unchanged. So for 44, the correct option, of course, is D, all the above. Then 45, these are simple questions. If you have heard of the terminology, it may or may not have been covered in current affairs. Still, it is quite often in news and, you know, you can easily, like virtual reality, digital signature. So that is there. Then this is again about wearable technology. There's no specific news which will come if something happened, but wearable technology is prominently there we see developments. So what is wearable technology applications? That is the question. So in the context of wearable technology, which of the following tasks are accomplished by wearable devices? So with wearable devices, you can identify the location of a person, sleep monitoring can be done, health monitoring can be done, you know, assisting the hearing impaired person. So these wearable devices actually accomplish all these functions. So 45, again, the answer is D. For 46, you have RNA interference. Technology has gained popularity in the last few years. Why? And there are four options given. So this is a little difficult question, you can see. It says, first, it is used in developing gene silencing therapies. So RNA interference is basically for gene silencing. So first statement is correct. You will have to go in a little detail. This is Wikipedia coverage on RNA interference. Then second is, it can be used in developing therapies for the treatment of cancer. Yes, there have been steps taken for that. And also, out of the four options, you can see all four cannot be correct. So you have one correct. If one correct is correct and two is correct, then you are left with only A option, 1, 2, and 4. So it can be used to develop hormone replacement therapies. There's no such development done with RNA interference. And 4 is also correct. It can be used to produce crop plants that are resistant to viral pathogens. So RNA interference, this is a little difficult question. If you have covered about this technology, you would be able to solve it. Otherwise, it may be difficult. Then 47th question. Recently, scientists observed the merger of giant black holes billions of light years away from the Earth. What is the significance of this observation? So when black holes merged, we could detect gravitational waves. So this was prominently in news. 47, the answer is B. It has been covered in news also. You can see we have also covered it up. This is ripples of discord. So regarding detection of gravitational waves. 48 is, which of the following are the reasons for the occurrence of multidrug resistance in microbial pathogens in India? So why does multidrug resistance take place? First one is genetic predisposition of some people. So genetics has never been come up, you know. Multidrug resistance has quite often been in use, especially with respect to TB related cases. So one is not the case. Second, taking incorrect doses of antibiotics to cure diseases, of course, is true. So two is surely true. So one is incorrect and two is true. So then all depends on fourth one. So third, it says using antibiotics in livestock farming. So when antibiotics are used in livestock farming and livestock consumption taking place, animal, you know, consumption taking place, antibiotics enter into human bloodstream too. So of course, when indiscriminately used in livestock, it affects humans too. So two and three are surely true. And fourth, it says multiple chronic diseases in some people. So when there are multiple chronic diseases in some people, directly it may not result in multidrug resistance, because they are suffering from multiple chronic diseases. But if they don't take the correct dosage, you know, taking incorrect doses, etc., is the reason. So this option never comes up in any reason for multidrug resistance, that people are having multiple diseases. So here the correct answer is B, 2 and 3. So here is the answer, 48B. So this has also covered in news, you can see, with respect to TB. So multidrug resistance. So here you can see multidrug resistance, ninth. So here you have multidrug resistant TB. So drug resistance is caused by, you can see, incorrect prescription, erratic supply of drugs, poor quality of drugs, and patient non-adherence. So these are the options, you know, reasons given for drug resistance. So we have the correct option, that is 2 and 3. Then next is 49th question. What is CS9 protein that is often mentioned in news? So CS9, this is CRISPR technology, if you recollect. CRISPR CS9. So that has also been quite often in news. We have covered it quite often. You can see here too in news, CRISPR CS9 technology. So here it is. Biotech, how safe is CRISPR? So we'll look at it. So this is, you can see in 29th July news. So this is CRISPR technology, DNA editing. So CS9 comes here. So that is the protein which is used for cutting. So you can see CS9. So here, then looking at the options, you will be able to say what is Cas9 protein that is often mentioned in news. A molecular scissor used in targeted gene editing. A biosensor used in detection of pathogens. No. Gene that makes plant pest resistant. No. A herbicide substance. No. So of course, the correct answer, only one relevant option, is A. Molecular scissor used in targeted gene editing. So it's CRISPR Cas9. CRISPR is gene editing technology, is quite often in news. So if you know about CRISPR Cas9, you will be able to answer this question. It is A. And the last one is, which of the following statements is not correct? So this is regarding hepatitis. So this has also been covered in news, you can see. So here we have this coverage of May 2018. So this is regarding hepatitis. So we have hepatitis news covered here, drive to control hepatitis on number 5. So here you can see, this is regarding hepatitis. So if you look at the types of hepatitis A, B, C and D, there are 5 main hepatitis viruses. Vaccines are available for 4 but not for hepatitis C. So with this much information too, you will be able to solve this. It says which of the following statements is not correct. So out of 4, one statement is not correct. So it says, B statement says, hepatitis B, unlike hepatitis C, does not have a vaccine. So hepatitis B does not have a vaccine is what it means. It means hepatitis C has, but unlike it, B does not have. It's rather reverse. Hepatitis C does not have a vaccine, B has. So B is the incorrect statement, that is clear. Then you can look at others too. Hepatitis B virus is transmitted much like HIV, that is true. Globally, number of people affected with hepatitis B and C is several times more than those infected with HIV. Again, this is statistical data. But if you know about option B, you will be clearly able to solve this statement. That's the only way, because one of the statement is not correct and B is clearly not correct. So that is that. And say some people, those infected with hepatitis B and C virus, do not show the symptoms for many months. Again, you may or may not know such information like C and D, but still you can easily solve this question with this much information. So for 50, the correct answer is B. Hepatitis C, there is no vaccine available. So that is it. This is the second part of our GS Paper 1 UPSC Prelims 2019 detailed analysis. In third part, we'll cover further questions.